All right, here it is. The showcase. Let's go.
Oh, we're finally doing this, are we? Because I was going to make a sandwich.
Okay. I feel like this is loud.
Let's do it. What do I think about heroes? Well, we've all seen them, haven't we? Swanning about the place with their disproportionately high cheekbones and comically massive weapons.
Fable.
Roughing up bandits, because
Fable.
They like to rough up bandits, don't they?
Fable.
Living it up with the common folk every single night. On a day-to-day basis, I'd say the true hero's me.
Who's
someone
Fable?
Who's making new ground with fruit, with veg, on the agricultural side of things. Just
look at them. This is Fable.
Not wafting around mythical creatures. And that's what they are. Wafters.
Yeah, well done.
You see, I'm not here to slay legendary beasts. I'm here to conquer the vegetable, not a euphemism. Let's face it, the age of heroes is over. This is the age of innovation.
It's Fable.
This, if you will, is the age of death. One moment.
Wait, why do I have... Why is my closed caption here?
This is awkward.
The theory.
Yeah.
Oh. Ah! Yes. Yes. I love this. I'm down. I like this. Oh my gosh, this is so exciting. Oh, she murked Dave. Poor Dave, but no date. Okay, so CGI.
World premiere.
A world premiere. All right, oops, sorry. My bad. There we go. I'm trying to like check things as well.
All right, Twitter up.
Don't have no mercy in this land. Just don't have no mercy in this land.
This looks like that movie.
You look in the bed and somebody be gone. Just don't have no mercy.
Shaking bones. Been a while. So, you remember that favor you owe me? I'm looking for a creature. Huge, sneaky. Teeth like knives.
This looks so interesting.
No.
What was this? What was that movie? Kobo?
No.
It's like that type
Nobody?
Of.
Not helpful. Mm-hmm. Sneaky.
What is this? This looks cool. Oh my gosh, that looks cool. Oh, my hair is like all over the place. Hello, everyone. There we go.
Hello, everyone. World. Just kind of running into this right now. I had to also stop the stream because it's giving issues.
These are dangerous times. At least that's what I hear.
Star Wars game.
They're everywhere. But the world here belongs to the syndicates.
Yo, okay. I think I had to lower it down a bit.
I have to play their game. Looks like I'm all in.
She's in here somewhere. So it's like rebellion? Okay.
And now I just need a chance.
Do you hear like kind of like the bump 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 of the Mandalorian, like the grandness of
We're here to offer you a way out, okay?
Get off my ship, Jalen.
Give me a chance. You're gonna have to trust me.
The soundtrack, it's like that grandness of the Mandalorian. It's interesting that Ubisoft isn't showing this at their showcase. I will say because it's CG, maybe they're showing gameplay at Ubisoft Forward.
The underworld shows no mercy.
But I like that this is really, it looks like it's going to be very story driven.
And I'm going to risk it all.
I'm excited. Outlaws. Okay. I'm here for it. I'm here for it. Coming next year. I'm actually surprised we actually got it coming next year. Gameplay. Exactly what I was saying. I feel like I need to make myself a little smaller here. Let's.
Wow. Fable. South of Midnight.
Sarah Bond.
Star Wars Outlaws.
Nice.
Welcome
to
our first ever double feature. The Xbox Game Showcase. Followed by a deep dive into one of the most important RPGs ever made, Starfield. Gaming.
Most important RPGs. Okay, all right. Okay, I'm here with you.
It connects us, and it's just incredibly and awesomely fun. That is why Team Xbox is committed to building the greatest place to play. By partnering with the most ambitious of game creators, and by unleashing the power of the gaming community. Enabling all of us to play the games we want with our friends anywhere, from mobile devices to PCs to consoles.
All right, let's see.
The lineup we have for you today is just incredible. These are the works of the very greatest creative teams from around the world.
The music's very like.
We made this show for you, the largest, most engaged, and globally diverse fan base in Xbox.
I don't know if I like the music. It seems like I'm being drafted.
You are the heart and soul of Xbox. Your passion drives us, and you are the
inspiration
for
the
visionaries whose games we showcase today.
Ah.
Me and all of the team.
Sorry about that.
Inspiration for the visionaries whose games we showcase today.
Okay.
From me and all of the team at Xbox, thank you. This next game is from Thunder Lotus, the award-winning studio behind Spiritfarer, who've gone back to their combat roots with an amazing co-op raid-focused action game that is uniquely theirs. All right, everybody, it's time.
I gotta tweet out this.
World premiere.
Thank you. don't know what is going on with, like, me trying to stream anything. Just kind of doing its own thing right now, I feel like. Like, it's so choppy, my stream. This, I'm not interested really in this. I mean, sure, like, this type of game is good for some people. I just don't know if it's good for all. Immortals, sure, not for me. Yeah, I mean, I feel like I have to stop the stream. There's something, like, the internet is, like, bugging.
All right, guys. Okay. It's a simple job. Just in and out. Nothing to it.
Payday.
Everybody hit the floor.
I actually never played Payday, which is crazy because I know it would be my type of game. It would totally be my type of game. Payday. I don't know why I haven't gone to Payday. I really don't know why. Why haven't I played Payday? That's the question. Why haven't I played Payday? Okay, alright. They started off the showcase with Fable and with Star Wars Outlaws. Like, those are pretty big games. Like, usually you would end the showcase with that. So they must have something super Persona. Oh, wait. They must have something super good to end the showcase with. And I know, like, it's the deep dive. Yeah, Persona. Nice. Anyways, I got distracted by Persona. Persona, like, music, you get distracted with. And it just looks so beautiful. Anyways, what was I saying? Yes, for them to start the showcase with Star Wars Outlaws and Fable, Fable and Star Wars Outlaws, is telling me they have to have something really big to end the showcase with. Or they just really want people to dive into Starfield, which, I mean, that's probably what they're going to do because the game showcase ends with Starfield, to go into the Starfield Direct, I guess. But, I mean, there still needs to be a big surprise. Assassin's Creed? I will say there is a lot of like, for both Fable. Oh.
People don't like you very much, do they? Sent here to the Living Lands.
No.
By an emperor who couldn't bother to come himself.
Is this a... Avowed?
To investigate some plague that seems to be corrupting our very souls. You want us to trust you. But the truth is, you scare us.
This is not.
The way you fight.
This is not.
The secrets you keep. You're either here to save us. Or destroy us. So now that you have all this power, what are you gonna do with it?
Yeah, it's about okay. It looks good. I keep losing track of what I was saying, but I will say at the top they were showing a lot of CG trailers. Here we go, Banjo. Cause Star Wars? Oh, is there like a... Wait. Monkey Island! That makes so much sense. That just makes sense. Why... I didn't even think about that before. That makes so much sense.
Ship, a luxury ship, a ship with just a splash of je ne sais quoi.
The legend of Monkey Island. You mean Governor Guybrush. But Freeport's not set foot out of that mansion for almost a year.
Hey, what do you think you're doing? I told you no autographs. Though I see you have a meet and greet ticket. And I guess it's not every day that you get to meet the mighty pirate Guybrush Threepwood. The legend.
That is so interesting. So he's coming to Sea of Thieves. That's so cool.
The Chuck has turned the memories
the Monkey Island's being added. That is really cool. That's a really cool crossover. It just makes sense.
Well, well. What do we have here?
You need these.
Things may be very different. From the Sea of Thieves, you know.
Hold on!
That's really cool. A new original story. That's really cool. I'm gonna have to dust off the Sea of Thieves
world premiere
account. I feel like I could be a little smaller. How can I? Come on. Oh, this is singing close to home, everyone. It's your air rescue? Sure. How is this going to come in? How? This is like a cool idea. I think like Flight Simulator needs this if it is like an expansion on Flight Simulator. I just wonder what the like objectives are and how it all comes together, because there's so many different things, like from air racing to glider pilot to scientific research. Like there's just so many things that you, it seems like you can do. So it's like, is it like different paths and like different missions for that path, and then you move on to like hot air balloon trips and then move on? Next Flight Simulator. I think that makes sense. I feel like that's what Flight Simulator needs. It's a really beautiful game, but that other element of like the purpose of flying makes sense. Dune crossover, that's crazy. Good for Flight Simulator with the crossover that no one saw coming. I don't think anyone saw this one coming. Maybe I'll bring my volume down. I think, I don't think anyone saw that one coming. Long live the fighters. Dude. That's really cool.
Hi, Melina here, speaking to you from our performance capture stage at Ninja Theory, where we have just wrapped our shoots for Senua Saga Hellblade 2. When we first showed gameplay for Hellblade 2, it was a look at some of the game's cinematic and immersive action, where Senua faced off against a gigantic troll on the Icelandic coastline. Today, we're taking
I can't wait to
Senua's
play
story,
this.
Her personal quest, her unique perspective on the world, and the intimate journey that awaits you in Senua Saga. What you'll see today is all captured by the team on Xbox Series X.
All right. I'm really excited for this one.
She can feel them slipping through her soul, following the threads of her mind. She's here to find them, the ones who hide. She needs their help with a promise, a question. Never so simple, is it? Wisdom has a price. There's always a part of you that changes. A part of you that darkens. And a part of you that dies.
Over there, that pool.
Yeah, I'm this looks so good.
They can see us. What is going to happen? It's time to find out. How can we make it happen? It's time to find out. Why are they watching? It's time to find out. What are they waiting for? Senua, what are you waiting for?
I'm here. Where are you?
What do they want?
I don't like it.
I'm scared.
This is too mad, woman.
Their eyes everywhere. I can feel them.
Yeah, this looks so good.
What is she supposed to do? Do something. Oh, ask them.
What do you want me to do?
Oh, your soul forth through hell to find us.
You were lost. Not anymore.
Are you ready for what you will find here?
What we will find? What if it's all for nothing? What is that?
Everything I've done has led me to this place.
We've come so far.
Not far enough. Say it.
You are ready.
Tell them. I am here. Now.
What if we get lost forever? What will happen to them?
What will happen to you? I will not let them down.
She is ready.
All right.
They know.
Go.
That is so cool. I thought it was supposed to come out this year. Is it Dead Island or something? Oh. No. I thought... Yakuza!
どこだここ
Oh, it got pushed back. I didn't realize it got pushed back last month.
Oh my god, a streaker!
A streaker.
なんだよ
Oh no, it didn't get back, pushed back in May. I guess I don't know if I thought Senua. Like a dragon. All right. Bethesda presents. At least they're going trailer. Fog. Fallout. I was like, Fall Guys? Fallout?
Promise plucked from post-atomic blight, the fruit of years of prudent progress and determined reclamation, and 15 million dwellers worth of keen imagination. From the heart of West Virginia to the depths of the pit.
Well, we owe it all to Vault 76.
No matter if you roam alone or spend your time with friends, you'll find a home in Appalachia where the good times never end. There are relics to uncover from a time before the war, along with loads of friendly folks to meet and enemies galore. Our world is always changing. Greater foes are overthrown as we embark on expeditions into thrilling new unknowns. Yes, from Appalachian settlements to Nuka World on tour. You're never short on things to do or places to explore. Think you've seen it all, eh?
I know a lot of people are into the, like, Fallout series. It just never grabbed me. Which, again, it is something that I feel like I would be really interested in. Just haven't got to it.
So there you have it. Now you know. There's a million ways to make the wasteland your waste home. And when you hear adventure calling, when you're looking for some kicks... Answer the call.
Oh, they changed it up. I was gonna sing along with them, but never mind.
Play it now with Xbox Game Pass.
Okay, that makes sense. Coming to Game Pass. In Atlantic City. Coming soon.
World premiere.
I feel like they probably need to announce a new Fallout after Starfield. The scares. It's scary. Oh, that's cool. I still don't know what it is. Of the goddess. Okay, Path of the Goddess, I see you. It looks similar to other games I've seen. But I mean, hey, if I see more of it, I check it out.
General Motors' historic commitment to performance is embodied in two of its iconic brands. Chevrolet and
Forza?
Cadillac. The V-Series.R elevates Cadillac's competitive spirit to a whole new level with its thunderous V8 and hybrid power. The legendary Corvette has been a celebrated champion for decades. The all-new Chevrolet Corvette E-Ray continues that tradition. General Motors is proud
obviously it's going
to
be beautiful.
To usher in a new era of competition with the innovators behind the new Forza Motorsport.
Forza Motorsport and General Motors are pairing their strengths in technical excellence and sophisticated modern design to take bold steps into the future and bring that experience to gamers.
That looks like something out
to
of
Forza. The Cadillac V-Series.R. and the Corvette E-Ray.
It looks so beautiful. Every Forza.
I know you're ready. You've got this. Let's tweak the car's performance for the next one. I'm feeling the vibe, taking my time light. Big with the maze, making my shine bright.
Whoa, I gotta make it, I'm going sky high. Never hold back. Man, if only I had a nice car. If only I had a nice car.
was your best lap yet.
This is my timeline!
I've seen all that ever was, and all that ever will be. I have seen betrayal, endurance, ambition, and courage. I am the one who knows.
Skyrim-ish.
For perhaps the first time in my unending existence, I feel disconnected from fate's flow. Unseen forces move against me.
Elder Scrolls.
Forbidden knowledge.
What is this?
A mystery long kept hidden. A secret that threatens to unravel reality. Itself.
Oh, what just happened there? What is this?
Save Tamriel.
Elder Scrolls. Okay, that's online. Okay, cool. Getting an update there.
Cesis Unit 37. Toronto is under attack.
OWL.
Null Sector.
I mean, well, Overwatch.
There's something different about Null Sector this time.
Toronto's under attack.
They've taken over most of the city and they're rounding up Omnix. They need our help.
Overwatch really needs. Really needs this. Like, Overwatch really needs this. Feels so, like, I just want that community to get some love, you know?
Maybe we can save the city.
Coming through.
Been a while, Vivian.
As if I didn't have enough problems already.
So we fly up there, smash through anything that gets in our way, and focus on other business.
I hate to interrupt the moment, but I'm picking up reports of more attacks in other cities.
It's a fight they want. I say let's give it to them.
All right.
Engage. Target mark.
Time to create peace.
Co-op events. That's cool. Trying to also keep up with the Xbox Twitter to see like what information they're releasing as they're releasing information on the showcase.
Shall we do this together?
Fight with me!
Engage it.
Watch this!
I saw that. Not bad.
Okay, that's cool. So they're coming to Game Pass. That's cool.
What is this place?
It looks like we're in a palace.
There's Sona.
What is going on?
Who are these people?
No idea. But if they're attacking us, our only choice is fighting back.
Hey, look over there!
Can you get us out of here?
So you're telling me you're thieves?
Oh, it's like a strategy.
And you just happened to stumble into this world? The Rebel Corps will always help the Phantom Thieves, just as the Phantom Thieves have helped the Rebel Corps. Never forget that we're a united force who can rely on each other.
You should be grateful to have been made my subjects, but you're just matterless little brats.
Unfortunately, returning will be no easy feat. Somewhere deep inside, I know you realize things can't go on like this. So, will you take a stand beside us?
Yeah! Let's show them what we got!
P5T. It's Persona Tactic. This would be cool on, like, cloud gaming. Like, mobile. I'd play that.
Humanity has always hunted
Starfield.
For knowledge.
Wait, is
unknown.
That... Was that the showcase?
The wonder is... Not that the field of stars is so vast... But that we have measured it.
Was that the showcase for Xbox? Are we going into the Starfield Direct? How long is that? Oh man, I cannot wait for this. Cannot wait. The Star Trek nerd in me is so excited.
We're all here because we're committed to the biggest question of all.
I think you might have heard that burp.
What's out there?
Yeah, sir. 38 minutes. I'm going into the Starfield Direct. I guess that's why they paired it. It's like, it's really focusing on Starfield.
You're part of Constellation now.
I thought we'd have the game showcase for like maybe almost like an hour, and then the Starfield Direct would be like 30.
No finer group in the stars to be unraveling this mystery.
I'll follow you from here on out, Captain.
Oh man, this looks so good.
I love this part.
These artifacts could be everything we've been looking for. Another great secret the universe is asking us to unravel. Human settlements throughout the galaxy could be at risk. We are not stopping. Whatever lies at the end of this road will change humanity. Forever.
Looks so cool.
This is where we belong.
Looks so good. Oh, looks so good. September 6th. I gotta like finish everything. Everything by September 6th. I feel like this is the one. Oh. So we're not at the end. That's weird. I thought that would be the end of the showcase.
World.
Interesting.
Premiere.
I guess they still want people to feel that hype and then come back. Like I thought maybe Sarah would come out and be like, hey, we got the Starfield Direct. But before we do, you know, that kind of thing, but no. Okay. So we got more of the showcase. like a fruit fly flying around right now. It's very, very annoying. This is cute though. This looks cute.
There, it's like literally like, I wonder if you guys can see it. Can you see it? It's like all over the place.
Oh, this is cute from Don't Nod. This is cute. I'm pretty sure this has like a good story. Don't Nod is good at that. Say? I couldn't read it properly. What is that? What was it called?
World premiere.
I'm just trying to kill the fruit fly. Imagine if they reveal the Kojima game. That looks cool. That looks cool. It'll be interesting. Play it day one with Game Pass. A lot of things coming to Game Pass. Is it? This looks really cool. I want to play this. I want to play this now. I want to play now. Is it available now? You got skateboarding? Dungeons of Hinterberg next year. All right. I actually want to play that one, and it's going to be coming to Game Pass. That's really cool. There's a lot of things, though, coming out next year.
Hi. I'm very excited.
He's back.
To be returning as
He's back.
Silverhand.
Keanu
and the
is
upcoming
back.
Expansion for Cyberpunk 2077.
Is
Phantom
Do they have
Liberty.
Idris Elba? As well,
this new
that'd be
adventure
cool.
Reunites Johnny and V on a dangerous spy mission and introduces Idris Elba as secret agent Solomon Reed. It's really amazing to share the screen with you, Idris. It's cool to be a part of this game with you, man. As a player, you'll get to visit Dogtown.
I mean, how can you not like Keanu Reeves? He's just so like,
and rescue the
I feel like he's very
of
authentic,
the
very
States
authentic
of
person. I've
Expect
never met him,
a massive
but.
Expansion.
As Canadians, we're good people.
Secrets and plenty of stuff to do.
For the most part.
I know the team at CD Projekt Red just keeps raising the bar when it comes to telling cinematic stories in video games. And I really can't wait for you to play it on Xbox Series X and S. But enough talking. I'm guessing you want to see for yourself. And so it is my honor and pleasure to give you and introduce the official trailer for Phantom Liberty.
Okay.
Check it out.
check it out. And he runs on the screen.
There's got to be a way out of this.
I'm dying.
I love that.
There's nothing can stop that. V. My name is Songbird. I'm an NUS intelligence analyst. I know about the bomb ticking in your head. And I can save your life.
What's the catch?
I need you to get to Dogtown.
Attention all Dogtown residents. President managed to crash her Space Force One into our humble district.
Man's got 1,001 reasons to want Myers as a hostage. Sleeper agents. Time to wake them up.
So NUSA's tossing us back into the fray, huh?
Stay sharp. We're in the wolf's den now.
Get Myers out of there.
Time to evac.
Her safety is the top priority.
Shit! They catch us out here, we're dead.
Wait, hear that?
God almighty, it's moving! Run! This way, quick!
Someone ratted us out.
You know, V, treason ain't ever black and white.
It's a charade, V.
Wherever she goes, people get hurt. Bodies drop.
Just want what Songbird promised me. The cure.
The situation has changed. You need to know if you're with me.
Illusion of freedom draws in the desperate. Pick your truth, V.
Come on. Got iron in your head. Gotta put it to someone's head. Pull the trigger.
If I don't do anything... and do it soon, I'll die.
Coming out September. All right. I actually want to play Phantom Liberty. I really want to play Phantom Liberty. In game. Okay, I'm really excited to see more in-game content. Oh, is this like, City Sky? City Skylines. Is this City Skylines, this game? I haven't played it. Only Sims. Sims is what you play. You make cities. You make the cities, all the cities. It does look beautiful, though. Probably will not play this one, though. It's just, I just don't have time. I don't.
Premiere.
陛下のお命が奪われるなど。
何時定めを課せられし子よ、憂いを抱える旅人よ。
こいつら俺の凱旋者だ。
果たして誰が次の王か。
己自身に命じなさい。内なる英雄の姿に変われと。
They have like very similar symptoms. Very similar systems to Persona.
まさか人間？
この国は今有史以来の危機にさらされている。
どうやら面白い力を手にしたようだ。
主君に捧げると決めた覚悟そのものだ。
これこそ人間の真実だ。
道は二つに一つ。
またあったね。やはり君は興味深い。
The mirror of reality.
正義かどうかじゃない。
誰もが恐れと。
By the way, this Costco has like this diet green tea.
あなたの持つ小説。
It is really good. Like it, I don't like diet taste things, but this green tea is really good. It doesn't. You could barely taste the artificial sweetening of it. Or is it stevia? Maybe stevia in here.
World premiere.
All right, this is what I want to see. Let's go. Let's do it. Right to us, as Keanu Reeves does.
Humanity's cities have fallen. Our people's only means of survival is to seek sanctuary here.In the Belfry. You must explore this world to find the origin.
You know what? Like, everyone, I think, like, people were talking, like, online. I've seen conversations about action adventure, third person, like, over the shoulder third person fatigue. I have to say,With the Xbox Showcase, you're not seeing a lot of that. Which is good for some people if they're tired of that same kind of, like, formula. I'm actually itching for, like, a really good story game. Over the shoulder, third person, action adventure. Because I don't get tired of anything. What is this? Towerborn.
World premiere.
All right, give us a good one. Give us a good one.All right. Lady Ironwood.
This city is a miracle of progress. A finely tuned, delicate.
Imagine if this is like another Bioshock or something.
But it only takes one rebellious little gear to ruin everything. If you resist my rule.
Is this Outer World? Wait.
If you alter our past. If you threaten what I have built.There is nowhere in space or time where I will not destroy you.
Oh! He got choppity'd. He got choppity'd. Choppity.
What did I do?
Any last words before my friend puts one in your scalp?
Oh, dang. Clockwork Revolution. It looks really good. That looks cool.
Thank you all for joining us. Today is a special day for me and the team. I'm excited to see 11 games showcased from our first party studios. We opened with Fable from Playground Games,
yep,
which will bring the franchise into the modern
era. I am so excited for that.
While staying true to its British style and humor. Compulsion and In Exile shared their first original experiences since joining Xbox with South of Midnight and Clockwork Revolution. And we are thrilled at how Avowed is shaping up for release next year from the RPG masters at Obsidian. In addition to Avowed, our studios will deliver Hellblade 2, an all-new Microsoft Flight Simulator, Towerborn, and more in 2024. Later this month, players can look forward to Elder Scrolls Online Necrom and Sea of Thieves Monkey Island.
That's so smart.
Holiday,
Sea of Thieves Monkey Island?
Starfield and Forza Motorsport, both built for Xbox Series X, S, and PC. We are also honored to share 14 games today from our creative partners, like Star Wars Outlaws from
Outlaws
Ubisoft
looks
Massive,
good.
In collaboration with Lucasfilm Games, 33 Immortals from Thunder Lotus, Kunitsugami, Path of the Goddess from Capcom, and more Persona games coming to Game Pass thanks to our continued partnership with Sega Atlas. I'd also like to congratulate the Studio Zero team on Metaphor ReFantazio. It's great to be able to premiere what is next from the creators of Persona here in our showcase. We are focused
It was a good showcase. I just
no
wish a lot more of it was
Xbox,
coming
PC,
sooner or had
or
dates
cloud,
to them.
All gamers are welcome here at Xbox.
The cool thing is a lot of it's coming to Xbox Game Pass,
consoles,
which again just proves Xbox Game Pass is
first, we have significantly increased our supply
a good deal.
Of Xbox Series X, making it easier for fans to find globally.
Sweet.
Second, we know you've wanted more storage with Xbox Series S, and I'm excited to share we have some news there as well.
Oh, what's coming? An external storage? Back in. Oh, is it a next version of the Series S? Man, the black does look so good. It really does. It's, hey, it's same price. So does that mean the old one? The old Series S is not
and
like...
And now for the one more thing you've all been waiting for.
Here we go.
Prepare
one more thing.
For the most comprehensive
oh,
deep
Starfield
dive we've
Direct.
Ever done
See,
for the
I
biggest
was...
game we've ever built.
Phil, I wanted one
so
more thing before
Starfield
the Direct.
Direct.
All right. I would say overall the Xbox Game Showcase, it's good. You know, an hour long. They showed like opening it with the games we wanted to see: Fable, Star Wars Outlawed. They teased it. At least Fable, Star Wars was a surprise. I think. I can't wait to see more in Ubisoft Forward. What else? And like there were like some like cute gems, all lot coming to Xbox Game Pass. I think I wanted to see more gameplay trailers, maybe more like specific dates. And I mean they pulled in Keanu, so they brought him back. Keanu times two. I'm really excited. I'm really excited for Starfield.
Hey everyone, thank you so much for joining us today.
All right, Todd.
To
Bethesda Game Studio.
Todd Wallace. You know,
we've been so lucky over the decades to make the kind of games that we love here. And that's thanks to all of you. From the Elder Scrolls to Fallout, we love creating these worlds and playing in them just as much as you do. And throughout all that time, we'd often talk about and dream up the space game. What if we could take that feeling of being who you want to be and exploring a new world, but set it in space, where you weren't really limited in where you could go or what you could do? And that is Starfield.
All right.
Obviously, we've come a long way since then.
I have, like,
with the games we've built, our technology,
right now,
and all
really
of us here in the studio. We've done
Starfield.
So much together, but, well, we've never tried to make a game like this. Today, you'll get to hear from many on the team and see so much of what we think makes our game special. So let's jump in and take a look.
I don't know how long the Starfield Direct is going to be. I do have to, like, leave in a bit, but I'm going to try to catch
Starfield
as much now, and then I may go back
in
and
25 years,
record more reaction
RPG
of it. Or I may just talk about it on my socials.
Where you step into a new world, and you get that feeling of unlimited possibilities.
Like, it looks so good.
But this time, it's not just one world.
Like, look at the... Oh my goodness,
it's
beautiful.
Over 1,000 worlds. Because
Jesus
the choice
Christ.
Of where to go, it's not ours, it's yours.
It looks so
and
good.
It wasn't until now that we had the technology to create it. From the rocks at your feet to the mountains in the distance, to the people and creatures that live in these worlds. That isn't just a backdrop. That moon is actually there orbiting the planet. Yes, you can visit it too.
That's sweet.
We realistically simulate the galaxy around you.
Like, holy
crap. Our next generation lighting model
this looks
uses
so good.
Real-time global illumination to light the world based on the type of star and the makeup
like everything
of
I've
the planet's
seen
atmosphere.
From Starfield looks like it could be a Game of the Year contender.
We also have an all-new animation system. And of course, you can play it in third person. And you can play it in first person.
Yep.
We love exploration and rewarding it, but you do explore differently in this game, given its scale. That usually involves exploring an area you've landed in. You can collect resources, do a mission, and maybe even stumble upon something unexpected.
Spacer punk.
We do love stuff and all of the items allowing you to pick everything up. And you can view all that in your data menu. This is the hub for everything you're doing, from your skills to your ship, your missions, and your inventory. We love to pack a ton of detail in every object, from all of your weapons to spacesuits to food. We just obsess over the details. We obsess over food. When you're done exploring, you can walk back or fast travel to your ship. We have companions and crew you can take with you. I left Vasco here back at my ship.
Welcome back, Captain Howard.
And he can even say your name. Let's head out.
That's really cool.
Our mission was to convey the wonder and majesty of space exploration, to evoke the romance of the golden age of early spaceflight. And we've been referring to this approach as NASA Punk. This means a design language where the tech is advanced, yet still looks grounded and relatable.
Yeah,
for
and
us,
that's what I love.
That's where the visual interest is.
About that.
Obviously the NASA, which is the rigid, hard, function over style.
The NASA punk
and then
that they're
punk, which is
describing.
All about style.
Because like that's
see
what
that
I think
style
of
coming through in your ship.
When I think of Star
your
Trek
ship is your home
or like
for
any of those
you
old
and your crew. And like many of the spaces in our game, it has a slightly retro and analog touch. a bit of lo-fi rather than sci-fi.
Straight from Star Trek, I love that.
And lived in.
Alrighty, what's the plan, Captain?
This is your star map. It starts with the planet you're currently on. You can see all of its info and resources. You can choose a landing spot or fast travel to known locations. Backing out further, you can view all the planets in the system. Obviously, the game is big, and it's here you can see planets that have key locations, missions, or life on them, versus the many planets that are barren but resource-heavy. Zoom out even further to see all the systems in this part of the galaxy.
Jeez.
Here, you can plot a course to ones that are light years away. This uses your ship's grav drive to fold space and jump to these systems. And you will need to upgrade your ship and skills if you want to jump to the most distant ones. But for now, we'll plot a course to the Alpha Centauri system, where we can find the city of New Atlantis.
I'm like, I know, I'm sorry I'm not talking. I'm just like, really, every time I see this game, I'm just like, god dang, I want this game now. But even if I had the game now, I wouldn't be able to play. Like, I'm still in Tears of the Kingdom quite a bit.
As soon as you land in a city like New Atlantis, your eyes are guided upwards to just these boundless, vast buildings.
It's the biggest city we've ever made, not just in size, but also in the amount of custom art, crowds, and quests.
So the main focus when we're designing a city is obviously what supports the story. We try and tell as many small stories as possible.
This is a Colony War memorial.
It's a few moments of gameplay that make the space feel like it's full of real characters that are going
like
about
the lighting
lives.
On this, like, even the reflections on the glass, like, it looks so beautiful.
It's also where your adventure with Constellation begins.
Welcome to Constellation. We have a lot to talk about.
By the time you meet them, Constellation is sort of seen as this mythical group. Most people don't even know they exist anymore. They're the last true explorers in the galaxy, and they're trying to find the answers to some of humanity's biggest questions.
The artifacts are so different, so alien, and I'm certain one of them reached out and spoke to you.
The wow. Artifact.
If you could place it on the table here.
Oh my god. Look at how it's coming together.
That means there's a set.
Built by an intelligence outside the settled systems.
It's definitely an eclectic cast of characters. You've got Sarah Morgan, the ex-soldier and adventurer, now Constellation's leader. Mateo, the theologian who believes that there's definitely something else out there. Noelle, the gifted scientist and Sarah Morgan's protege. And Walter, a very successful businessman in the settled systems and Constellation's financier.
Anything goes as long as you have the money.
There's also Vlad, the ex-
pain, no pain, no
Sam
gain.
Co, the former space cowboy, and Barry.
You know what I hate about these pirates? Completely resistant to my otherwise irresistible charm.
The journey you take with Constellation is just the first of many you'll embark on. The settled systems is home.
That's the only thing with Starfield that I haven't
and adventures for you to uncover.
Got yet is like the charm of the other characters in Starfield. I haven't seen too much of that. So I'm really wondering if I'm going to be
colonies is where you'll find New Atlantis,
caring about these
the
characters.
First major human settlement in space. The people who live here value law, discipline, and the legacy of humanity. They consider themselves the true children of Earth.
You ever think of joining up with the Vanguard? Help the United Colonies, even get your UC citizenship?
New Atlantis okay. isn't the only city within the United Colonies. The city of Cydonia on Mars to this day serves as the largest mining facility for the United Colonies.
In every space thing, Mars is always the mining colony.
Beyond the
all
United
the time.
Colonies' reach, you might find yourself in a much more wild and independent like the coalition expanse? Of
Think
star
about
systems.
It.
This is Freestar Collective Space.
Oh, it's like the Wild West.
The capital of the Freestar Collective is Aquila City.
The Stone Root Inn is an Aquila City fixture.
A ranger relies on judgment and intuition to do what's best for the people.
Neon started out as a fishing platform, but is now known throughout the settled systems as a pleasure city where almost anything goes.
If you've got morality issues, this definitely isn't the job for you.
All the parties are going to be happening here.
The best and brightest of today for our future tomorrow.
Everyone has been chewed up and ground up by Neon. Try not to get yourself
Ooh.
Killed, all right?
Dang.
Outside the bounds of civilized space, there are still plenty of unclaimed systems to explore, but these areas are also home to the most hostile factions in the galaxy.
The great serpent hungers. All heathens shall be made dust in time.
A new face. This is the face of a brave runner here to challenge the Red Mile.
They think the galaxy is theirs. They are wrong. It belongs to the Crimson Fleet. It
Work
always
hard.
Has.
Ooh.
In Starfield, we're pushing our cities and settlements further than we ever have before. It's all there, waiting for you. A slice of humanity's future.
So, ready to get out there?
Throughout the galaxy, there are so many things to see and stories to experience. But the most important story is the one that you tell. I'm the type of person who spends hours in character creation, and I think people are going to be really excited when
all
they
right,
see all
see.
Of the improvements we've made.
One of the
That's
biggest
cool.
overhauls was done through our character generation system. We scanned a wide range of faces from different age groups and ethnicities. And by mixing and matching all that data, we were able to create highly detailed and diverse characters.
We use that exact system to create all of the characters and NPCs you're gonna see in the game. So any character you see almost always is a character you could make yourself.
It's like, you can spend
hey,
hours
on
character customization,
okay,
so the more options,
you were out
the
cold.
Better.
No physical damage. Mentally, the jury's still out. You know who you are? New recruit for Argos Extractors? Ring any bells? Any of this look familiar?
You start your character creation journey as though you're cycling through employee records. You'll pick from a lineup of 40 presets, and that'll be your starting point.
Oh.
Your journey from there can
so
be
there
as detailed
presets.
Or as quick as you want it to be. This new system has more to offer than ever before.
Oh, okay, I
it's
see.
Also the simplest character generation system we've ever had. We let the player get as close as possible to make whatever they want, with the various facial morphs you can blend together, the dermesthetic and makeup, blemishes, scars, piercings,
that's really cool.
It's a lot, but I think it's the most fun to use.
Character creation is more than just how you look. This is also where you start to decide who you want to be. That's where backgrounds come in. Backgrounds
Ooh.
Give you a bit of backstory and start you out with three basic skills.
I
want
to be
an
explorer.
From chef to dusty. You know, the crew still has a betting pool about which restaurant critic you must have crossed to wind up here.
What's great about backgrounds is you never know when yours is going to come in handy. You could be in the middle of a fancy restaurant, talking to some guy, and suddenly you learn he needs a beast hunter to help track down a monster.
Fine. I probably should stick
that
to
is
professionals
really cool.
anyway, given what happened the last time.
We're also giving you the option to customize your build even further by letting you pick up to three traits. Traits are completely optional, and they come with their own advantages and disadvantages.
Neon street rat, like
you
that.
You could choose to meet your biggest
alien
fan.
DNA.
By the terror, by the terror! Is it really, really you?
He'll join your crew, and he'll give you gifts, if you're willing to put up with his constant commentary.
I can't believe I get to stand near you, breathing the same air.
I've got to have every molecule.
My favorite trait is kid stuff. You that's have to lot. Pay some credits that's, to that's support a lot. Your parents, but they're very sweet, and it's really fun to go visit them.
Honey, we got ourselves a visitor.
Oh, my God.
I came across some hostile zealots in space, but because I had chosen a trait that made me the same religion as them, I was able to get by without any issues.
There's another great that, is that gives so you a cool. damage buff when your health is low, but mercenaries will randomly show up and try to kill you. No matter what you choose, there will be plenty of ways for you to tell your story. And if you want to remove a trait, there are ways to do that too.
What a view! It's a feast for the eyes! Off we go to another adventure!
We'll let you discover that on your own.
Oh my god! Oh my god! If he's too annoying, just apparently you could just get rid of him. Oh no, I would never be able to.
Once you've built the perfect character, that's when your journey can really begin. We took what we loved about skills and perks from our previous games and put them together to create an all-new skill system. Each time you level up, you get a skill point, which can be used to unlock or rank up skills. Ranks are unlocked by completing challenges associated with that skill. Challenges become increasingly difficult as you work your way to higher ranks. With our 5 different skill trees and 4 ranks per skill, there's a lot to choose from.
I like the xenosociology skill because it lets you mind control aliens.
Boost pack out of the gate. I'm boost packing everywhere.
I like maxing out my physical tree so I can get neuro strikes and just punch my way through combat. That one's a lot of fun.
Invest in the skills that suit your playstyle.
I'm very much a stealth player. So, I'm out there pickpocketing everyone. My favorite part about being stealthy is slowly creeping through vents like you're in a movie. And then jumping out and springing on people?
That's so cool.
Whenever possible, I like to talk my way through situations.
Is the area off limits?
Fine, I'll issue you an access card.
I'm more of a run and gun player. I like doing the death from above thing where I boost pack over guys and I throw landmines at them. I like blowing stuff up.
I do too. I think I'm like more that I would like I could sometimes be a stealth player, but then I get really impatient and then I just start running and gunning. Looks so good.
Exploration is a key aspect of all our games. In Starfield, there are full star systems with new life, resources, and adventures. Our team worked hard to strike a balance between fun and realism. We studied data from NASA and a multitude of other sources to help us make the world feel believable.
My goodness, it looks so good.
From the way we approached planetary atmospheres to the way we placed biomes based on the planet's distance from the sun. Once we had created a grounded world, we can start looking at all the things that make that world fun. When you leave a planet and head into space, you'll be navigating asteroid fields, having chance meetings with interesting strangers, dogfighting in space, and exploring derelict ships. It's all out there. Ultimately, it's about rewarding your curiosity, because whether it's on the surface of a planet, the alleys of a city, or the vastness of space,
like, I like how there's so many different types of environments that you could interact with. It looks so big. A little overwhelming, because I feel like I'm gonna need a lot of time. And I may still be in
space
Spider-Man.
Space exploration is possible, thanks to your ship.
Or getting
your ship is almost like having another character or home you can make all your own. I think you'll be blown away by the amount of stuff you can do. You can buy a ship.
Yeah.
I'm sure you can find something you like.
Customize and upgrade that ship. And hire a crew to keep it up and running.
September 6th.
And it all starts in spaceports. Every spaceport has a ship technician where you can purchase, sell, and modify ships.
Anything I can help you with?
Maybe you start off with a speedy fighter that's perfect for bounty hunting. Then you might
round
out your ship roster with a hulking space freighter to run cargo missions.
But I feel like even a month and a half, like there's just so much that you can do. I think I'll be in Starfield and then I'll make the shift to Spider-Man October 20th.
And you have two ways to do that. You can quickly upgrade individual systems like your weapons or shields, or you can deep dive and enter the ship builder mode. Here you can change anything from the systems to the look and layout. Adding a new habitat module can give you more room for crew. Adding cowling can change your ship's overall silhouette. An improved grav drive allows for longer distance space jumps. You can even fully customize your paint job to get the exact look you want. The parts you choose to build with don't just affect your ship's stats. They'll also affect what you can do inside your ship. You can have modules for crafting or for storing and displaying your weapons. Starfield's in-game ship manufacturers bring their own look and feel to every piece of your ship. From living quarters to cargo holds, mess halls, and control rooms.
Oh, I love how like the screens are just giving that old like vibe.
Our
like that old
Frontier
space
is a practical
vibe.
Ship, but with a little creativity, your ship can look like almost anything you want.
It's a bit odd, but one of my favorite ways of customizing ships is I make them look like animals. The HMS Platypus, as I called it, where it had a giant tail to it. And we've done spiders, we've done mechs.
That so
really
is so cool.
Whatever your imagination is.
That is so cool.
And while you can build your home among the stars the way you want to, you're probably
so
not
cool.
The only person who will call your ship home.
And crew.
Ready to lift off when you are, Captain.
Engines ready.
The Frontier is fueled and ready, Captain.
Some of the members of Constellation can join you on your journey. These companions can serve on your crew, and they'll always be there when you travel.
We'll be traveling together until we either find an artifact or this lead runs dry.
Each companion comes with their own valuable skills for your ships and
Samco
outposts,
Barrett.
As well as unique quest lines. Eventually,
Barrett.
Some friendships might blossom into romance.
I don't know that I've ever really loved anyone except you.
And if you're looking for a little extra help on your ship, you can always hire additional crew at spaceports.
Got any room on your ship for someone like me?
You'll also meet potential crew members out in the world.
Still think there might be a spot for me on your ship? I gotta get off this rock.
Assign crew to your ship or outposts, and their unique skills will affect how they run. And just like companions, most crew members can lend a hand in the field. Take Bosco, for instance.
He's designed around the core basics of a NASA machine.
Please avoid getting shot. You might die.
I still wanted to give it almost a humanoid personality, so I elongated the limbs. This tends to make him feel more human-like and give him a little personality.
It is a shame. Exploration requires so much bloodshed.
Using the shipbuilding tools and crew selection features in Starfield, you'll be able to build and captain the ship of your dreams.
That's cool. Like, I just want to play it.
And now, let's take to the sky.
Oh boy, it looks so good. I just want to go into Starfield space. I want it now. Oh my gosh, look at how beautiful this is.
we're putting you in the cockpit of your very own spaceship. Jeez. And telling you that you can do pretty much anything. Mm. And that is really cool for us as developers. Spaceflight should be exciting and dangerous. And you should feel like you're in complete control every step of the way. We've extended that sense of warp system to ship combat. It's not about just hitting your triggers to fire your weapons.
Oh man, I cannot wait.
It's a complex dance between your piloting skills and our power allocation system. Boosting power to your engines will make your ship faster. Powering up the grav drives will shorten the amount of time it takes before you can make a jump.
That is so cool.
And moving your power to your weapons and shields means you're ready for a fight.
Shields at 70.
Be on your toes because you're not alone out there.
Oh my goodness, I cannot wait. Oh, look at it.
Unlocking the targeting control system skill will allow you to zero in on specific subsystems of the ship you target.
That is so cool.
After destroying an enemy ship, you can loot the remains from your cockpit. You can always turn any ship that engages you into scrap. But you can also take a more personal approach by docking with the enemy vessel and boarding their ship.
No way. I love this. That is so cool. I love this.
Once you've taken control of an enemy ship, it's yours.
I cannot wait.
Empty your fleet and retrieve it at any spaceport. But space is way more than fighting for your life. Just like when you're planet side, there are plenty of sights to see and stops to make on the way to your next adventure. Like these massive star yards. Walk the halls, talk to the crew, maybe get talked into buying a whole new ship.
A civilian in my star yard. Let's see about getting you a proper ship, one worthy of you.
Oh my god, I'm gonna spend hours with this game.
Like the UC Vigilance.
I'm gonna lose my life during this game. Like, I won't be doing anything to anyone. Like, with anyone. Now it just sounds all weird in my head. But I won't be doing anything. I won't be hanging out with my friends.
You can hail any ship you come across.
I won't be hanging out with anyone. I can't stop saying it. Okay.
When I'm playing, I generally go crazy. I definitely go like the more piracy routes. I want to take over ships. I'm going to board ships. I'm like, this is now mine. I steal all the sandwiches and put them, you know, in my cargo hold that I have specifically for sandwiches. I don't want to play the hero.
That's hilarious.
But I want to go out and just start taking things from people as quickly as possible.
Some strangers might be looking for a little human connection in the darkness of space.
Hello, stranger. I just finished cooking up some food. If you want to come on over, just pop on by.
Some of the best moments are the ones you discover on your own. The thing I love most about Starfield is that it is a Bethesda game through and through. It's really about going to strange new places, meeting interesting people, and getting sidetracked on zany adventures. Then, realizing 2 hours later that you're involved in a completely new story.
You're human. We thought we were the only ones to leave Earth.
That DNA is so present here. It's in our random encounters, it's in our handcrafted quests. And it feels so cool to play it and just make your own path in this universe. There are over 1,000 planets out there, just waiting for you to visit.
I like Dead Skin.
We want you to feel like explorers. Breaking ground on new planets, exploring every inch of a mostly untouched galaxy. We want you to feel hopeful. We want you to feel this sense of awe and wonder. And sometimes, a little fear. We're giving you a massive playground and a ton of toys, and just setting you free.
dialogue's so. I don't want to say it again, but I'm going to say it again. But that looks so cool.
Take a break and show you something a little bit different. You know, we put so much detail into our game worlds, and we love the opportunity to bring that into the real world with our collector's editions. And for this game, we've done a watch. It is the Constellation Explorer's watch.
That
is
the
watch that you actually get in the game that acts as part of your HUD, where it's the compass and then environmental information. It connects to your phone to give you notifications and other information. And we've also designed this really cool case that it comes with, Eastvon.
Yeah, we really took as much care and designed this case as we did the watch. Our attention to detail in the game totally translates to this. Inspired by the cases that the astronauts used during the Apollo era to bring back samples from the moon.
I think I want that.
It's got an intricate locking mechanism, authentic, heavy.
That is the locking patch, mechanism looks
strap,
so cool.
And the overall functionality and believability of this as something that would exist in the world, in the Starfield universe.
Oh, and hey, take this. You'll find it very useful out there. And it even tells the time.
That is so cool. It'd be
we
cool if it was like a smartwatch.
Now that we're part
I
of
do
Xbox.
Need a watch.
We get to work with the amazing people on the Xbox hardware team, and together we have created this custom limited
oh my god,
Starfield
I need it.
Controller. It's
I
awesome.
It
is now, you know, our favorite controller.
We love this because it's
that
inspired by the
so
actual
cool.
controls of your spaceship. And not only that, we've created the first ever custom headset with Xbox. And this is a
I want all of it. That honestly
we're
looks so pretty. The whole I need everyone to know that I know what's on my wish list for Christmas, for birthdays. It looks so good. Like that headset also looks so good. I think I want that headset. Oh. It looks so clean.
In every one of our games, we always put so much care into all those little details that breathe life into our worlds. But Starfield isn't just a Bethesda Game Studios world, it's a Bethesda Game Studios galaxy. So why go this big with Starfield? Because we want to give you freedom on a galactic level. The freedom to experience both the exciting planets and the quiet ones.
Like,
scanning
the quiet planet
planets
look so good.
Is a great way to get a sneak peek at the available resources you can use for crafting, building, and customizing.
That's the one thing,
cool
it's like...
This whole system that we generate the planet itself as a procedural content, but the handcrafted content itself comes as the player explore.
So
our system builds a planet as the player approaches it. We stitch together block of terrain. After that, we have the system that adds interesting locations for the player to explore, creatures to encounter, ore and plants to pick up. It allows us to add that touch of environmental storytelling that Bethesda is known for.
Aggressive creatures have been disrupting our experiments. Their habitat isn't far from here. If you could take care of them for us, we would be in your debt.
So even if your friends were to visit the same planet that you had, you would have a different story to tell.
I'm trying to... Tweet! That's so good.
It's completely up to you how you want to interact with each planet. Whether you want to explore and see what you can find, harvest resources and be on your way, or simply take in the views. With the help of your scanner, you'll chart the uncharted and discover exotic wildlife.
If you
have the skills. You can even figure out that certain creatures and plants, you can build an outpost and produce resources from those plants and animals. You can get experience and rewards for fully surveying planets and fully surveying a whole system.
When we were concepting these creatures, we really wanted to think of them as natural to the environment. We didn't want alien monsters. We wanted native wildlife. Something you've never seen before.
When it comes to our exteriors, when the sun moves, all that light is calculated in real time through the atmosphere. Our biggest goal for lighting with Starfield was to make the game feel more filmic, to use lighting and color to really make it feel more cinematic.
It looks so beautiful.
After some exploring, you can find a spot to set up a base camp. Outposts can be built almost anywhere on any planet. And the habitat modules come in all shapes and sizes, filling all different purposes. You can even live in them. Assign crew and companions to work at your outposts for added bonuses, and set up extractors to harvest resources while you're away.
Something cool we have this time is we have a new fly cam, where you can toggle between on-foot building, or you can now use a top-down isometric camera, which helps plan out larger parts of the outpost and placing those larger halves. So that way you can really plan your structures and what the overall feel of your outpost is. And then when you're on your feet, you can really decorate and fine-tune things much easier.
Add crafting and research stations in your outpost to utilize any resources you find or already have.
Mod your weapons to adapt them to your playstyle. Different weapon sights and scopes, larger magazines, a selection of grips and barrels, different ammunition like explosive rounds. All you stealth players out there will surely need a suppressor. You can also choose to go hands-on with melee weapons.
I think it's always a delicate balance between like what's realistic, what's sim, and what's Hollywood. And I think we sort of err on the side of like what's fun for the player.
With Starfield, we've completely overhauled our combat. It's more dynamic, the animations are more fluid. It just feels great.
We probably have more mods and more weapons in this game than, I want to say, any other game we've done before. There's a lot of variety.
Upgraded gear is just one of the many factors to pay attention to when engaging in combat. You may need to switch things up based on your environment. Gravity is different for each planet, and boost packs are excellent for getting around.
That's cool. I like how it's different.
And for giving you an edge in combat. Sometimes you'll even feel like you're flying. Zero gravity environments pose a different challenge. Firing a ballistic weapon in zero G will actually push you backwards. Energy weapons, on the other hand, offer a more stable shooting experience.
We also have mag weapons. These are high-powered electromagnetic induction ballistic arrays. Each barrel has its own targeting laser and can dish out some serious damage.
I like it. I like it.
Whether you want to get up close and personal with your own two fists, Or you like more compact weapons like pistols and submachine guns. Or maybe you prefer something bigger. Starfield's got you covered.
I cannot wait. He went flying. Flying. Wait, what? There's
powers? Thanks again for being with us today. We are just so grateful that you've taken the time and spent it here. I know there was probably a lot to take in. There's a lot to the game, even more than we could show here. You know, as we play it, we're always sharing these unique
and special powers
that only a game like this can bring.
You have force powers or something?
I think about what makes it special, it really is the people here.
Or maybe like how they were talking about that ancient civilization, maybe there's some powers you could harness there.
Putting something special of themselves into
it. I want to see more, but that's not what he did. Some of
their favorite moments.
I love the way that our final combination of all the new tech has come together to create some of the most beautiful sunsets and sunrises we've ever had in any of our games.
Yeah.
I love the creatures, the exploration, every biome is different. The word that comes to mind is vast.
I like to use our photo mode to take rock star photos.
I just love that constant feel of discovery and wow, I can't believe that there's more here.
I'm most excited about our outpost building systems.
My favorite part is every time you step out on a planet, it's a unique experience.
You spent all this time building your ship and you see it on the landing pad.
I'm really excited for this.
It's the kind of thing that you just can't get anywhere else.
I'm so excited.
There's something about seeing
a
tower over in the distance and going, I know the gravity's low here. I think I can make that jump.
My favorite part is biomes, spaceships,
audio design,
planets,
the day-night cycle.
Those details matter to me.
Diplomacy, exploration,
freedom,
the ending.
Vesco.
The ending.
I love the robots.
What
so
happens
much?
In the
incredible
ending?
Incredible amount of worlds we created.
Sniper rifles, come on. Lever action, rocket launcher,
brain sprout. I laugh, but some people might find creepy. I don't know. And that's where I've been.
The thing that I enjoy most about the game is the freedom to be who you want to be, do what you want to do. It's what you've come to expect from a Bethesda title, but on a much bigger scale.
On behalf of all of us, we can't wait for you to play Starfield and make your own special moments.
Constellation. Looks so good. So I guess like the artifacts makes that like the circle. Oh my gosh. I cannot wait till then. I think I need that. I think I need things. And it's this right here. I really like the watch. Oof. Ooh, so pretty. And the headset and the controller. I mean, overall, like the Starfield Direct was pretty dang good. I think they surprised us, especially left more questions at the end. with that tease to powers that we have not seen anywhere in any information that we got from Starfield. And also with that one employee that was like, that was like the ending. What happens in the ending? That's really, like, I'm really excited for Starfield. And also Senua's, like, Hellblade. Ah. Looking back at everything that they showed during the showcase and direct, it was a good one. It was a good one. I think they were able to surprise us. We, off the bat, we got Fable, which they teased. We got our first look at it, CG look at it. And then no one, I think, was expecting to see Star Wars, Ubisoft Star Wars Outlaws in here. We thought that would be for tomorrow for the forward, but they brought that surprise, and it was a good one. Clockwork Revolution looks good as well. It was good. And then, yeah, the Sea of Thieves in Monkey Island. It was good. Oh, I really want to play that game too. Still Wakes the Deep looks interesting as well. I think the only thing I wanted outside of the Starfield Direct is more specific dates, as well as more gameplay. I think that's all I think I wanted. But it was good. Overall, I think the showcase was good. It was a good showcase. You know, I feel like we are expecting at this time for everything to be like, it has to be wowing. It has to be like a surprise. We want to get, say, I can't even think of the game right now because I'm trying to look up Clockwork Revolution. But anyways, it was a good showcase. I'm like all over the place. I think like sometimes when we go into these showcases and directs and we want like the big surprises. So I'm pretty sure people wanted to see Elder Scrolls. They wanted, for me, I really wanted to see Fable. I got that. So I'm happy. I want to see gameplay though, but we probably won't be getting that till next year. I think like realistically Fable's probably coming out end of next year, like maybe fall time. So we won't be able to see anything from Fable probably until beginning of next year, or like, again, at the showcase, we'll get that Fable. Who knows? I do think that like it was a good showcase. I thought it was good. I don't know. I want to know what you thought. But I think there were things in there that very much interest me, that surprised me as well. Did I potentially want like the big surprises like Kojima to talk about like what's happening with this game? Yeah, I think we all do. But I think especially coming out of the pandemic, and I know a lot of people are tired of hearing, oh, well, you know, the pandemic happened. So, but that is a fact. The pandemic slowed a lot of production for games down. So I think keeping the expectations realistic for fans is very important. And we saw that in a lot of showcases. I think that's what they're doing by not getting too ahead of themselves. And I think that is the key. So if you are feeling like you wanted more from that, it's probably because you wanted to see like the big surprises, like Perfect Dark, or hear a new oldie coming back. But I think they do have to keep it realistic, keep it to like, what are you going to see coming next year? And they did do that. And it was good. I wanted just the only two things I wanted was more gameplay trailers and specific dates for releases. I think that would have, like, if we got a Fable release date, that would have blown it out of the water. Or even like fall 2024, that would have blew it out of the water for me. But that's just my opinions. I'm curious to know what you thought of the showcase, so let me know down in the comments. I know, like, I apologize as well if it was like a little choppy. they've been like drilling and doing so much work around my area that it's been cutting the internet in and out, but I really wanted to share my thoughts on the showcase with all of you, just to have that conversation going. I also was tweeting during the showcase, so the conversation will keep going on all my socials at this Camco everywhere, where you could find me and find more great things. I am hoping to be able to stream more of this content for you, but I need to work it out because, again, as I mentioned, they are digging a lot. It is affecting with the internet, but I'm hoping to stream more. If I can't stream more, you will be seeing more videos here of gameplay. I've been playing lots of Tears of the Kingdom, so I'll probably be sharing more Tears of the Kingdom gameplay with you. And yeah, you know, you could always hear my latest and greatest, you could always hear like the latest of like my opinions with games on my social media, but also on Autosave, which is a podcast that I do where we take you through a journey of games, like a deep dive chapter by chapter, playing through the games with you, giving you opinions alongside my co-host Nick. And right now, right now it's Fallen Order, and then we are going into other games. We've done like God of War Ragnarok, Spider-Man, Miles Morales, like, so you could kind of deep dive back into that. But then we also do these monthly episodes where we talk about all the gaming news, and that's where you really hear all my opinions. So be sure to check out my socials. This is Camco. I have a link tree in all my bios about Autosave, about everything I've been up to and the latest things I've been filming. You know, I was doing the Tears of the Kingdom reveal, so you could check that out if you missed it, that the launch of Tears of the Kingdom. I shot that in New York with Nintendo. And obviously I have my Rainbow Six stuff that I do with Ubisoft, so you could check all those latest videos, but there's a lot more to come. So please stay tuned. Thank you so much for supporting, and I hope to be doing this more right here. Thank you, everyone. Bye.